Hello. Unfortunately, I've been unable to remove the watermark in this video. Here, I'm going to talk about AnCorny optimization. But first, let's start with swarm intelligence. AnCorny exhibits what we call swarm intelligence, in which collective system is capable of accomplishing difficult tasks in dynamic and varied environments without any external guidance or control, and no central coordination. This is an actual video I took when I was in Holland. We said there's no leading bird, and yet they're all flying together as a flock. Another key point swarm intelligence is that they can achieve a collective performance, which is very unlikely to be achieved by an individual acting alone. For example, ants finding food in this big, wide world. And here we see that there were only a few ants at first, and after a while, a swarm of ants know where to find the food. These ants exhibit what we call stigmagy. They interact with the environment, modified it, which affects the ants' behavior, so they don't find the food directly by telling each other where the food is. How do they use stigmagy? They leave a pheromone trail. AnCorny optimization, in principle, is like this. The algorithm itself is inspired by real-world AnCorny, and is used to solve some discrete optimization problem. Each ant moves randomly at first, then each ant deposits pheromone onto the path. The shorter the path is, the pheromone signal gets stronger, as it is a positive feedback system. Then ants follow the path with the intense pheromone. Now let's look at how I implemented to solve the bean packing problem. Firstly, randomly distribute small amount of pheromone, between 0 and 1, on the construction graph as matrix T. Secondly, generate a set of Pn path from S to E, where P is a variable that represents the number of ants. Thirdly, update the pheromone in the pheromone table T for each ant's path according to best ant fitness. Fourthly, evaporate the pheromone for all the links in the graph. Fifthly, if a termination criterion has been reached, then stop. Otherwise, return to step 2. Here is the actual code on BPP. Of course, you may think it's too small, so now let's look at the video. The code is implemented on Python and you can test run it with Jupyter Notebook. If it's too fast, please pause the video. Here we have the function which generates SE, the path from start to finish. Then we have a fitness function which returns the fitness, and a lower value in fitness indicates a better path. And also the function for generating results and printing results. And now this is the main function. You can refer the code that I encoded or pause the video for a better look. This is a detailed description on problem 1. The algorithm aims at finding the optimum path for putting items of different weights into a certain number of bins such that the maximum weight difference between the heaviest bin and the lightest bin is kept to a minimum. Here we speed up the video a little bit. But in conclusion is that the setting of ACO with higher value in P number of ants and also higher value in evaporation rate E generates a better result. Here we have problem 2, which is similar to problem 1 except it has a greater value in number of bins and also a greater weight difference between items. And in this result we also see that with a higher value in P and E, the path generators is with a better fitness. And then last, there are two table summaries on what kind of problem ACO have been implemented to solve optimization problem by other scholars. The algorithm name, the year. There are quadratic assignments, vehicle routing problem. And of course, the most well-known problem solved by it is the traveling salesman problem. For more info, you can search online. That's the end of this video. Thank you.